If you get a chance of doing only one scan in the whole course of pregnancy, then you should go for an anomaly scan. No doubt, each and every scan in pregnancy is equally important, but this anomaly scan will give you the detailed information about each and every organ of your baby as well as birth defects, on the basis of which you can decide a very important decision of your life, that is whether to terminate this pregnancy or continue it further. What more information can we detect from this anomaly scan? Let's know all the things in detail in today's video. Do watch it till the end. Hello and welcome to Thrupti Wellness. This is Dr. Thrupti and we are talking about important scans in pregnancy. We have already discussed about early pregnancy scan, which is done between 6 to 8 weeks, and the NT scan, which is done between 11 to 14 weeks in earlier episodes. Do check the links in description for the same. Now moving to anomaly scan. This scan is done between 18 to 22 weeks of pregnancy. It is also called as mid-pregnancy scan, 20-week scan, anatomy scan, morphology scan, level 2 ultrasound, and also TFA scan at various places. Majorly, it is done after 18 weeks and before 20 weeks. Now, the reason behind this particular timing is before 18 weeks, the organs of the baby are not well formed, and according to law, especially in India, medical termination of pregnancy is legal only up to 20 weeks of pregnancy. In some exceptional cases, court allows the termination up to 24 weeks. So nowadays, this scan is performed even at 22 weeks. Now, how this scan is done? So anomaly scan is done transabdominally, means the probe is kept on your abdomen and a gel is applied, which is completely safe, and this is used to get more clearer images of your fetus. This gel acts as conductive medium between the probe and your abdominal skin. You need to fill your bladder before going to scan. Also, in some cases, there might be a need of transvaginal scan to measure the cervical length and also to assess any fetal abnormalities in detail. Normally, this scan takes around 25 to 30 minutes to check all the organs of fetus in detail. Many a times, baby is not in the favorable condition or lies in the awkward condition in the womb. Also, if the mother is obese or if she has any previous pregnancy scars, or if the baby is moving very faster, then it becomes difficult for sonographer to complete and to get the clear pictures in that particular time. At such times, your doctor or sonographer may take more time than usual waiting for baby to change his position, or also he or she may repeat the scan after some time gap intervals or advise you the repeat scan after a couple of days. Now let's see what are the parts examined during the scan. The first one is baby's head. Head circumference is measured to see that whether it corresponds with the weeks of pregnancy or not. Also, the shape of head is checked, and improper formation of skull, if any. Accumulation of fluid in the brain is also checked in this scan. And most important, impairment in brain development can be detected in this scan. The second one is face. Two eye orbits with two lenses, two ears, one nose, and lips are checked in this scan. Also, whether there is bridge between the nose and the lips of the baby or the opening is continuous is checked. Presence of cleft lip is detected here, so it will give the idea whether the baby needs any further treatment or surgery after birth. Also, the auditory opening are not visible in this scan, so this is the limitation of anomaly scan. The third one is heart. Four chambers are checked, two atria and two ventricles. Also, the opening and closure of the valves along with the heartbeats are noted. arteries and veins carrying the blood from and to the hearts are also checked here. This scan is capable of detecting 45 to 50% of heart defects. Again, this is the limitation of anomaly scan. The fourth one is spine. Length of the spine is measured here. Whether all the bones are aligned properly or not, whether the spine is covered by the skin at the back or not, all these things are checked. Also, the neural tube defects, spina bifida, are potentially detected in this scan. The fifth one is abdomen. Abdominal circumference is measured. Also, whether all the organs are closed in the abdominal wall or not, is there any rift or hole in the abdominal wall or diaphragm, is checked thoroughly in this scan. Whenever the baby swallows the amniotic fluid, that fluid gives the visible structure of stomach, so it is also checked in this scan. The sixth one is kidneys. Two kidneys on either side should be present. Is there any kidney missing or malformed, that is abnormal in shape or size, is checked here. Also, does the urine flows freely into the bladder or not? Whenever the baby sucks the amniotic fluid, this fluid is digested and excreted in the form of urine of the baby. So both digestion and excretion processes are functionable in the baby. So if the bladder is empty during the start of the scan, then doctor waits for some time to fill the bladder again. Conditions like pelviectasis means the dilation of renal pelvis is also detected in this scan. The seventh one is arms and legs. All the bones of hands and legs are checked. Measurement of thigh bone is taken. Also, whether all the fingers and toes are present or not, and is there any malformed or abnormal shaped limbs in the fetus. Eighth one is placenta. This scan detects the position of placenta, whether it is fundal, anterior or posterior, and if it's low lying, then whether it covers the mouth of cervix or not. If yes, then repeat scans may be needed to monitor it closely. The ninth one is blood vessels. Majorly two arteries and one vein which connects the baby's umbilical cord to the placenta are checked here. The 10th and most important one is fluid around the baby. The amniotic fluid present around the baby is measured in this scan. In India, as per PNDT Act, the genital organs of fetus cannot be detected in the scan. So the defects like absence of anal opening are not found in this scan, which is again the limitation. Anomaly scan helps to detect the structural defects or birth defects in the baby. If any of them are found, then the further decision is taken with the help of experts. These decisions are mainly taken on the basis of three factors, and those are whether that defect is treatable or not, whether it degrades the quality of life of the baby after birth, and whether it is compatible with life or not. With these three things, the decision of continuation or termination of pregnancy is taken. So this was all about anomaly scan or mid-pregnancy scan. We hope this information will help you. We will meet in next episode. Till then, stay happy, stay blessed. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, hit the like button and share the videos with the needy ones. Thank you.